The Anker F3800 and the EcoFlow Delta Pro Ultra were both super hot units in 2024. In terms of capability and output, these are number one and two on the market right now. Anker actually just released the F3800 Plus, which fixed a couple problems that the F3800 was experiencing. EcoFlow decided not to launch anything new in regards to the Ultra this year, which speaks to how good of a unit it already was. So which one is the best buy in 2025? Our answer might surprise you. So welcome back to the lab where our opinions cannot be bought. We have recommended and talked about both of these power stations tons in lots of our other videos. They're both great, capable, portable units that can also work for whole home backup. And they both come from the two most reputable and expensive brands on the market. And while a lot of you guys may not think that the F3800 actually goes head to head with the Delta Pro Ultra, in a lot of other comparison videos we have with this power station, you guys are always asking to see a head to head between these two. And to be honest, they have a lot more in common than you might think. And so today we're here to clear the air, share our opinions, and let you guys know which one is actually best for you. As always, here at the lab, we're trying to provide honest information, but we also want to save you guys some money where we can. So we'll have discount codes to both of these guys in the description down below. But before we jump into anything else, in case you're not already familiar with the new F3800 Plus, we're going to jump into a super quick head-to-head comparison to get you up to speed with both of these power stations. Right off the bat, both of these guys failed the tiny baby lift test. This weighs 136 pounds. I'm sure tiny baby could pick it up, but it's just awkward. It's big. To pick it up on your own isn't that easy. Delta Pro Ultra weighs 186 pounds, but it has the Pro being able to split in two and pick up half the weight on the top, half the weight on the bottom. So he actually technically can lift the Delta Pro Ultra. We have a 3,840 watt hour battery bank here, and we have a 6,144 watt hour battery bank in here. This guy's expandable up to basically 2,700 watt hours, while the DPU is expandable up to basically 30 kilowatt hours. The Anker has a 6,000 watt inverter. The EcoFlow has a 7,200 watt inverter. Both are capable of running 120 or 240 volts. The new upgraded solar input on the Plus is 3,200 watts, which is actually quite a nice improvement from the not properly functioning input on the old F3800, but it has nothing against the Delta Pro Ultra's 5,600 solar input. And both of these units, you can actually charge them with 120 or 240 volts, which is sick. It allows you to charge them up really, really quickly. And in terms of price, the F3800 Plus is currently selling for $3,199, and the Delta Pro Ultra is currently $4,849. Both of these guys love changing the price every morning when they wake up, so who knows what they're actually gonna be. And something key to know for this video is an expansion battery for the F3800, which doubles its capacity. The expansion battery is also 3,800 watt hours. It costs $2,099. An expansion battery for the Delta Pro Ultra, which is 6,000 watt hours, costs $2,499. So for what is basically the same price of this power station, you can buy this with an expansion battery. And then when you start to compare that battery bank with the inverter specs and everything, you actually have quite a showdown. The edge that the F3800 Plus has over the EcoFlow Delta Pro Ultra is kind of the same way that we think about like Apple versus Android. Everybody with an Apple product makes fun of the Android users, but at the end of the day, the Androids do have a lot more cool features. They're generally ahead of the curve, and they're usually a little bit cheaper. That's kind of the way we see a head-to-head between any EcoFlow and Anker product. And a great example of that is we have done some really in-depth testing with the F3800 Original and the Delta Pro Ultra. And those tests actually revealed some interesting results. So the edge, the first edge that we're talking about with this, is that it is actually kind of under-specced. It only has a 6,000 watt inverter with whatever the surge rating is. Surge ratings are garbage. And the Delta Pro Ultra has a 7,200 watt inverter with whatever its surge rating is. But when we were testing it under significantly heavy loads, we found the F3800 actually performed a lot better than the DPU, which no one thought would happen. It can lift a car on a car hoist, no problem. Somehow the Delta Pro Ultra has like a weird surgy, stuttery situation when it does that.
Okay, try two. Not good.
It can surge to start the compressor when running a ton more power tools than the Delta Pro Ultra can, even though on paper, the Delta Pro Ultra should be able to do that task better. So if you're using this for anything with a really high surge, or you're just trying to just spank it on a daily basis, this one may take that a little bit better. And as we kind of already mentioned, another pro for this guy is that if you buy it with one expansion battery, you actually have about 1500 more watt hours than you do if you just buy one Delta Pro Ultra with one battery. And it's roughly the same price as buying a Delta Pro Ultra. So if you're just doing one system versus one system, it actually makes more sense to go ahead and get this with an expansion battery versus just buying a single Delta Pro Ultra. And obviously a huge pro for this guy is it's got the wheels, it's got the built-in suitcase handle, it's got the little foldy handle underneath. It's meant to be taken around and team lifted, which is actually pretty cool. It's also really easy to just put it in a corner of your house. Like, it's really compact and tall. It doesn't take up a lot of floor space, which is really, really nice. And it stacks thin and vertical. So this is something that you could almost get in like a closet. You could get this anywhere, like in a slide out on your RV. You could easily lay this down and shove it in there. Delta Pro Ultra is just bulky enough that it might not fit as nicely in like an RV or a camper. A big one for me is if you're gonna be using these power stations on the go, which again, likely this would be the one you use on the go, the Delta Pro Ultra wouldn't be, but this has two more 120 volt plugs on the side, which can be very helpful. It saves you from having to run extension cords or expander bricks or whatever. And also has a 12 volt car socket right here on the front, which Delta Pro Ultra doesn't have anywhere, probably because it's meant to be inside of your house, not inside of the back of your Jeep. But if I were to take this camping or something, it has the ability to run 12 volt accessories off it, which is cool. And the Delta Pro Ultra does not. Something that's not an edge yet, but we can tell they're working on, is accessories for the F3800. The new F3800 Plus has this little door on the side. It's got a picture of a generator on it. I don't really know why, because the new generator plugs and stuff plug into the top port up here. We've all been kind of theorizing that that's where they're gonna start to utilize a bunch of new accessories. We can only hope. And finally, the price on this guy. The price is just better. If you're just doing one versus one, even if you don't have the expansion battery, it's just a cheaper, more affordable unit. And a plus to the plus is that the plus may make the F3800 OG actually a little bit cheaper. So if you're okay with some of the flaws that it had and have been corrected, we might actually be seeing that price come down quite a bit. And if it does,
stupid.
Nothing says good deal like a cheap unit with a discount code from the lab. The Delta Pro Ultra's edge, aside from just feeling like a little bit more of like a well-rounded, well-put-together unit, starts with the output. It's a 7,200 watt output as opposed to the 6,000 on the F3800. And while that may only be a little bit, as you guys know, it doesn't take a lot to actually push you over the top, especially if you're trying to use this for like a home backup. In that case, it's almost always better to go with the bigger option because you never know what your future power needs are gonna be. The Delta Pro Ultra also has a normal 30 amp plug that runs 30 amps. The F3800 has a 30 amp plug, but it only outputs 25 amps. So while that's cool, if you're gonna be using this inside of an RV or a trailer or something like that, most of the time you would want your 30 amp plug to output 30 amps. Most trailers, RVs, things like that, if they're gonna take a 30 amp plug, they're banking on having that 3600 watts coming out of that plug for them to access. So you may be pushing it with an F3800. The DPU also just has a better solar input. While the F3800 Plus just fixed their atrocious first attempt at solar, this is still a bigger, better, easier to manage system. We actually had this thing plugged in running off panels for like 6 months last year, just continuously cycling, powering our air conditioner in the garage, and it worked completely flawless. It was great, and it has a still significantly higher solar input than the Plus. This unit's also just built to expand significantly better. You guys can see how sleek and clean it looks. And if you wanna put more batteries, you just lift the inverter up, put a battery underneath it, and you're good to go. Like, it builds into a really big system really cleanly. It comes with supports and stability things that you can bolt it to the wall so it doesn't tip over or do anything. And it's just cleaner when you do. Like, the entire cord that connects the inverter to the battery is this. This is probably the coolest cord that we've ever seen a power station use to connect the inverter to the battery or batteries to each other. Whereas the cord on the anchor isn't terrible. Like, it's really soft. You can kind of bend it and get it right out of the way. It's not like the Blue Yeti ones that are just the worst thing ever, but it is still a pretty big cord. When this is plugged into the side, you got a lot, and you're starting to build a big system, you got a lot of cord happening. Not that it's all about the cords, but the point is this expands. If you get a couple of these, you can get it up to like a 90 kilowatt hour system with the smart home panel. It's cleaner and it's just built to be a big system. The F3800 is built to be a small system that you can also make big. EcoFloat also just generally has a better app. It's a little bit more advanced than the Anker one. I really like that you can put in your electricity rates and time of use settings and schedule all that right from the app for the unit. It's just a more well-rounded product in our opinion. And as of right now, EcoFloat has all the accessories. They have way more accessories than Anker does. You have the EV charging adapter that you can use. They have the generator charging cable. They have the EcoFloat smart home panel, which is comparable to like the Anker home power panel. They have the 50 amp hub, so you can actually pair two of these together without the smart home panel. They have wheelie cart you can get for this thing, so it's not on the tiny little trolley wheels that we have it on. And they have a couple extremely overpriced solar panel options, same as Anker. But point is, Anker is not there yet. They don't have all the accessories yet. EcoFloat does. All the ecosystem for all the other products mostly work together. Not all of them work with the Delta Pro Ultra, but they just have a really good vibe and theme with all the accessories that they already offer. And the last thing is that the Delta Pro Ultra makes more sense to build into a bigger system. Each battery is only like a couple hundred bucks more than the F3800 batteries, but they're significantly bigger in terms of watt hours. And so while initially this system may cost you more than getting into an F3800, if you're gonna scale it and build it up, it makes more sense to throw your money at something like this. It's gonna end up getting you a little bit farther than scaling a system like the F3800. The F3800 is built to be small and then scalable. This is built to be scalable. So at the end of the day, both of these are great options for home backup or light off-grid use. And if you've already narrowed down your decision-making to one of these two, great job. I really don't think you can go wrong either way. But in our opinion, here's what you should do. You should buy the F3800 if you're going for a smaller system and you want the best bang for your buck. Like we've already said, this with an expansion battery comes in pretty similar to whatever the price might be on this guy on any given day. And for that, you're gonna have an extra 1500 watt hours of battery bank, really similarly spec'd inverters and outputs and all that kind of stuff. And this unit performs really, really well. The F3800 is great if you want something that remains a little bit more portable. Well, you can get all the accessories for this guy. This just has the suitcase handle, the built-in handle underneath, the wheels. It's meant to move and be on the go. Or you want to take advantage of the potential of accessories that will be coming for the Anker F3800. Anker is a well-established brand. They've been making little gadgets and gizmos for the longest time, like over 10 years or something. And they have put the ports on this to get it ready for accessories. And I can only imagine they're going to do the DJI thing where they just make everything you could ever possibly want for this power station, because that's kind of what they do with other things. So if you're a fan of Anker and you actually believe in the brand, or you just want something portable, or you're going for a smaller thing that you want a better bang for your buck, I will go for this guy. On the contrary, we would buy the Delta Pro Ultra if you're going for a bigger setup. If you're going for something for whole home backup, you're gonna be ending up buying multiple batteries. This will end up just being the better unit. This is meant to be more stable, more stacked in the corner. They have ways where you can actually fix like the batteries and the inverters as you stack them to the wall, make sure it's not gonna tip over. And like we said, your money goes a little bit farther. It's gonna cost you more money, but the price of this expansion battery is not much more than the price of this expansion battery, and it is significantly bigger. And so once you start really putting your money into it, you're gonna get a little bit further with this. Or if you're trying to actually run a system with solar, again, you're gonna have a lot better luck with this. You have a significantly bigger solar input on this unit. It's also an easier solar input to work with. I know it's got the high and the low input, the same as this guy has two inputs. I don't know why these guys are doing it to us, but they're doing it to us. Regardless, this is a bigger input and it's better for you to work with. And the final reason would be if you actually need more than 6,000 watts of continuous output. It's only 1200 watts more, it's only 7200, but if you need like 6500 watts of continuous output and you're only trying to buy one unit, this would be the unit for you. But that's our opinions. Let us know yours. If you're still not sure, go with your gut. Whatever you do, make sure you guys use one of our affiliate links in the description below. It helps keep Tiny Baby fed, as you can tell he was today, because he didn't blurt out 250 things because he was hangry in the corner. No. Otherwise, make sure you guys are subscribed to the channel. We have bigger in-depth videos on both of these units right here if you want to check them out. That's all we got for you guys. Thank you so much for watching. We will catch you in the next one. Peace out and stay charged.